Searching through drum sounds, especially kicks and snares, can take up some serious time. One way to deal with that is to create kits in Drum Designer. Now, you can create an entire drum kit, or you can use Drum Designer to sample through some of your favorite kit pieces, and that's what I want to demonstrate here. So let's go ahead and create a new track. And we need to find Drum Machine Designer. And it's a blank one. There's nothing in here right now. So I'm going to go into my media browser and we're going to find some kicks. All right, so I have some acoustic kicks. I'm going to make a little kit of these. Drag the first one in. I like the second one too. So I'm just dragging it over the square and dropping it. Drag that one in. Get a variety of sounds. Try 13. Let's take 17 and put that in there too. All right, that's enough for now. So you'll notice it's starting at C1 and it goes this way and then goes up here. This is E1. So it's C, C sharp, D, D sharp, E1. If I play through the keyboard, it's just going to play through those samples right up through those keys. All right, so now we can save this. We'll call it Kicks, Acoustic, Cashmere. And I'll put a 2 next to that because I think I already have one. And then I want to save it inside of my user patches. So I'm going to save, go to Drum Kits, and save it right in there. So now it's right in my group of drum kits, and I can get to this anytime just by going there. Looks like I accidentally created a track. We'll delete that. So I've got my Kicks Acoustic Cashmere 2, and let's just go ahead and record in a little pattern. Okay, and we'll quantize that. All right, just a basic pattern to demonstrate what we're going to do here. I'm going to close up my library, open up my editor, my piano roll. Now select all of these. Now that I have them selected, I can start going through my different kicks. So I hit the play, Option key, upward arrow, goes to the next one. So you can see how fast you can sift through all of these kicks. Let's do the same thing with our snares for a second. I have this in a Drum Machine Designer 2. Select the bottom row. That's what it's on. Start the play, and then I'm just going to hit the Option and upward arrow. So once again, I can go through all these snare samples and listen to the ones and see which one I like. It's really convenient. It's a quick way to go through, sift through different sounds. What's kind of important is in your library to make sure you put names and categorize these so you can get to the ones that you want quickly. So if you name them and it lets you identify what type of kick or snare or whole drum kit that you have, that's what's going to speed up your workflow.